Bitwarden desktop version 2024.10.0 is no longer free software. This is an issue opened up a couple of days back and has been getting shared around various self-hosting forums, Hacker News, Reddit, and various other techie places. As such, a lot of the discussion in this issue is kind of off-topic, not really relevant to actually addressing the issue, and the moderators have locked the discussion. However, not before a lot of discussion has been done, a lot of confusion about what's actually happening here. Is Bitwarden no longer free software? Was it ever free software? How does the Bitwarden model actually function? We'll get to all that, but before that point, let's have a look at the issue. Pull request 10.9.7.4 introduces the Bitwarden / SDK internal dependency which is needed to build the desktop client. That is this one right here, and we can confirm that dependency in the package.json file. That is this one right here, SDK internal 0.1.6. The dependency contains a license statement which contains the following clause: you may not use this SDK to develop for use with software other than Bitwarden, including non-compatible implementations of Bitwarden, or to develop another SDK. So we can go and confirm this over in the repo, Bitwarden / SDK. The license file is this one right here. This makes use of the Bitwarden Software Development Kit License Agreement. This is a custom license made specifically for the SDK. Under Section 3, SDK license from Bitwarden, Section 3.3, you may not use this SDK to develop desktop applications for use with software, so on and so forth. Now, with a term in your license like this, this is definitely not open source, as this discriminates against certain fields of endeavor, that field of endeavor being writing another Bitwarden implementation. It's also pretty arguable that it's not free software, as it probably violates both Freedom Zero, the freedom to run the program as you wish for any purpose. One of those purposes might be implementing another Bitwarden implementation, and the freedom to study how the program works and change it so it does your computing as you wish. If you can't modify it to make a new SDK, that would be limiting that. I think it is pretty fair to call this source available, and Bitwarden actually agrees with me. We'll get to that in just a bit. And as he says here, this violates Freedom Zero. It is not possible to build desktop v2024.10.0 or likely current master without removing this dependency. Namely, trying to build with Bitwarden license directly removed, like we have always been doing, and sanitize node modules results in the following. Basically, a bunch of errors saying it cannot find the Bitwarden SDK internal. Also important note, it doesn't just apply to the desktop client, it also applies to the browser, CLI, and web clients. Basically, all of the Bitwarden clients are affected by this change. Now, we'll get into the response from Bitwarden in just a moment, but before we get to that, the community response is basically what you would expect. Time to leave Bitwarden, time to fork Bitwarden. This is the spirit of open source dying. This sucks. This isn't shitification. All of the stuff that you would expect to see when something like this happens. However, some people think about it for a little bit longer and are kind of clued in on what's actually happening. One comment I saw was people completely misunderstanding what this means, which is a very good way to put it. Now, I do think Bitwarden is partially at fault for people misunderstanding what their business model is, and I have been misled by it as well. So Bitwarden likes to advertise themselves with the term open source. Bitwarden is an open source password manager. When there are news articles about Bitwarden, they'll say similar things. Bitwarden, the open source password manager compared to LastPass, the proprietary password manager, or things like that. And I've made the same mistake myself on this channel because, for the most part, Bitwarden is open source. For the most part. However, the project as a whole is not an open source project, it's an open core project. I'd imagine a lot of you probably haven't heard the term open core before. It's not a super popular model, but it is growing in popularity, especially amongst a lot of corporations. So the idea is you have this core FOSS project that is open source, is free software, whatever you want it to be. Pick your favorite license, whether it's Apache, MIT, or anything else, it's fine. So you can use this project as a standalone thing and not really worry about it. This project is open source. However, as a whole, the project with all of its additional features, this isn't, because you have additional features being compiled in from proprietary repos, from source available repos. So the final thing you get in the end is a combination of the core open source project and a bunch of proprietary additions. Now you might say, I would never support a project like that. I would never support that model. Are you a GitLab user? Because this is also the model that GitLab uses as well. You have the open source community project, and then the enterprise version, which has a bunch of additional features on top of it, but the core project is still open source. And the way you do these proprietary additions doesn't just have to be, oh, you can't see the source code, it is only internal to the company. It could be source available, and this is exactly what Bitwarden does. Let's have a look at the Bitwarden client repo. This makes use of a dual licensing system. Most of the project is GPL v3. So pretty much everything in this repo, GPL v3, with the exception of files located in the / Bitwarden license directory. Those are using Bitwarden license v1.0. Now, yes, it does sound similar to the Bitwarden Software Development Kit license agreement, but the Bitwarden license agreement is a different license, but it is still a source available license. And the same model is also used for the Bitwarden server as well. Most of the project is AGPL v3, because that just makes more sense if you're trying to GPL a server. But then things in the / Bitwarden license directory, those use Bitwarden license v1.0. What is very important and what is very different in this case compared to what is happening over here is you can build the project entirely without the Bitwarden license directory or any other projects that have the Bitwarden license attached to it. In this case though, a dependency that has the Bitwarden license attached, the SDK, this is a required dependency. And before you get angry at me saying, oh, it's not source available, it's open source, Bitwarden themselves are completely honest about the fact that this is a source available license. Bitwarden software licensing. We have two tiers of licensing for our software. The core products are offered under one of the GPL open source licenses, GPL v3 and AGPL v3. A select number of features, primarily those designed for use by larger organizations rather than individuals and families, are licensed under a source available commercial license. This links to the Bitwarden license agreement. Now, like in this case, the issue is where they kind of blur the line between open source and source available, making the source available thing kind of built into the fact that the project exists. So this was pointed out in a separate issue by Dan Brown, who I've previously had on the podcast. Open source license clarification on the passwordless server. This project is all about dealing with passkeys, and this is licensed under a single license, the Bitwarden license agreement. Hi, I just came across this project via recent blog posts that have been shared to Reddit. I just want to raise that the licensing involved is a little unclear right now, which may impact adoption and contribution. The recent blog post, Bitwarden passwordless page, docs page, and project repos all currently indicate or advertise the project specifically as open source, but as far as I can tell, none of the parts involved are provided under what would typically be considered an open source license. Again, it's a license they fully agree is source available. So over here it says, Bitwarden passwordless.dev hits general availability, and they make use of the term the open source offering. Over here, strong passwordless authentication in minutes. If we search open source, if I can spell, thorough third-party assessments of the Bitwarden passwordless.dev open source code over here, open source, all passwordless.dev code is open source, right here, an open source client-side library, and here, oh, that's the license. Following this, a developer responded. What they did is took the JavaScript client library and then updated this one to make use of an Apache 2.0 license. But it doesn't address the rest of the project, which is still licensed under the same source available license. Based upon your response, I'm assuming the server component is intended to stay under a proprietary source available license. In that case, my original point still somewhat remains. The blog post describes this as an open source offering. The doc states all passwordless.dev code is open source. These statements, or generally referring to passwordless.dev as open source, may end up misleading folks that think they're choosing to use an open source and therefore potentially self-hostable platform instead of a proprietary platform with an open source client. As an additional note, the Bitwarden license agreement as applied to this repo is somewhat awkward when applied to a tangential project like this. A lot of that license is referring to commercial modules, but it's not clear if this comes under that definition or it's just Bitwarden software. If it's the latter, then not much in that specific license applies outside of limiting liability slash warranty slash support requirements, and no specific rights are granted or prevented. Now, the point of me saying all this is it's not a matter of Bitwarden moving further away from being open source. The project, as it exists currently, is not a fully open source project anyway. It uses an open core model. Now, blending those two close together, that is problematic, but the project already wasn't open source anyway. And this has already caused issues trying to get Bitwarden over on F-Droid. License is not FOSS compatible, and on F-Droid, everything has to be FOSS. And this points out the Bitwarden Software Development License Agreement, the SDK that we've already been talking about. At the time, this got a response from the CTO of Bitwarden. There are no plans to adjust the SDK license at this time. We will continue to publish to our own F-Droid repo at this link right here. But this isn't regarding it being a requirement to build the repo. And after all of the feedback on this one, the CTO responded to this as well. Thanks for sharing your concerns here. We have been progressing use of our SDK in more use cases for our clients. However, our goal is to make sure the SDK is used in a way that maintains GPL compatibility. Right now, that's definitely not the case. One, the SDK and client are two separate programs. Two, code for each program is in separate repositories. This is not actually relevant, because if something proprietary is a build dependency, it's definitely not free software. You maybe possibly could argue it's open source, but it's probably not open source either. Three, the fact that two programs communicate using standard protocols does not mean they are one program for purposes of GPL v3. This would be the case if we had a GPL server and then a proprietary client. If they're just communicating over HTTP, the GPL license doesn't affect the other one. That's not what's happening here. This is something pointed out by Julian Claude over on that F-Droid issue. The claim is rather absurd. While ultimately that's for judges to decide, and I don't know precedent, the intent of the license is to allow two programs to communicate over standard interfaces without both needing to be GPL. Make no mistake, this is not what happens here. The SDK is directly embedded and called in shared memory. So as is the common understanding, and this is a very common case to import one module into another, they constitute a combined work. You can find a detailed explainer in GPL on mere aggregation. Where's the line between two separate programs and one program with two parts? This is a legal question which ultimately judges will decide. We believe that a proper criterion depends both on the mechanism of communication, exec, pipes, RPC, function calls within a shared address space, etc., and the semantics of the communication. What kinds of information are interchanged? If the modules are included in the same executable file, they are definitely combined into one program. If modules are designed to run linked together in a shared address space, that almost surely means combining them into one program. And that is exactly what is happening in the case of this SDK dependency. With all that being said, being able to build the app as you are trying to do here is an issue we plan to resolve and is merely a bug. So you should be able to build Bitwarden without the SDK, without the Bitwarden license repo, with the node modules being sanitized. The fact that you can't do so, at least right now, is said to be a bug. Now, this has been known about as a problem since at least July, when they tried to get it into FDroid, at least that attempt at doing so. There have been attempts in the past that have also failed, but the recent attempt failed because of the SDK and because of its license. If this issue actually gets fixed, I will believe it is a bug. However, there is precedent for Bitwarden not actually fixing licensing issues like this and just leaving them in this weird source available state. For now, it's still in a weird state and is still proprietary. If they fix it, no harm, no foul, but we'll see what happens. But what do you think of the situation? Do you like the open core model? Do you think it is a problem if the SDK is source available and then built into the open source project? I would love to know. And if you use Bitwarden, let me know down below as well. If you like the video, go like the video. And if you really like the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out the Patreon, Scribes, LiberaPay linked in the description down below. That's going to be it for me, and I'm probably going to keep using Bitwarden because I just don't want to migrate to something else, because something else is eventually going to do something funny as well.